Is it? Can't help this fucking out. Is this?
Hi guys, I'm Ken Mostek. I'm a professional photographer. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I appreciate you joining me. I'm recording today's vlog right here in my home office here in Denver, Colorado. On my channel, I like to provide behind the scenes videos when I go out on photo shoots. You can kind of see what it takes to do a photo shoot. And I also like to give tips and tricks on certain videos about some photography equipment. Today's topic, wireless microphones. Now, when I'm talking about wireless microphones, I'm not talking about the entire setup. I'm not talking about the transmitter, you know, the body pack. What I'm talking about is this piece right here, which is the microphone itself, the cable, and then the connecting end right here that goes into the body pack. I've got 10 tips for you on how to handle this very delicate part of the wireless microphone. And I'll also give you some tips on how to attach microphones properly when you're doing interviews and recording out in the field. Now, I do have some experience with wireless microphones, actually extensive experience. I was a television news photographer for over 20 years, all across the country. I've used wireless microphones for a very, very long time. I am currently using the Sennheiser EW100 series. They're great microphones. And this isn't really a review of the Sennheiser microphones or Bose microphones or whichever ones you want to use. They all have this same piece, and this is the part that's very important. So I was just on a video shoot, and this part of this microphone started to cut out on me, and I was getting bad audio, kind of like you heard in the beginning of this video, where it was cutting in and out and making all kinds of noise. It's this little section right here that comes in right through here. It tends to break. This is a very thin wire, and the wires that are inside of that are very thin, so they break very easily. So this microphone is no longer any good. I have a new wireless microphone right here, $130 at B&H, just to replace this part of this cable. And if you don't have this part of this cable, your whole wireless system will not work. If you find these tips helpful, do me a favor, like this video and share it with any of your other friends, coworkers who use wireless microphones, because they might find this helpful as well. Also, I'm really close to reaching a goal of mine for my channel. I'm just about at 100 subscribers. I know it doesn't seem like that much, and you know, there are YouTubers out there that have hundreds of thousands, if not millions of subscribers, but for my small little channel, which I've just barely started, 100 subscribers is a big deal to me. So if you could please help me out, subscribe to my channel. Again, share this video with all of your friends and coworkers who, you know, may use wireless microphones, who are photographers, who might find, you know, behind the scenes videos interesting. I would really appreciate that. Thank you. Okay, enough of that. Let's get to it. Okay, tip one is basically what I've already been talking about. It's this end of this microphone, this wireless microphone. You've got to be very careful with this piece right here that it doesn't bend, you know, too much like that. I can do this with this one because it's already broken. So please don't do this. If it gets down like this, those little wires in there can snap. So be very careful. Try to keep that as straight as possible. You've got to be careful on this end too, the part with the microphone. This can break as well if you know, this part coming right into the mic here, if you were to, you know, really tug on it and make that a sharp turn, that can break as well. So be careful on this end. Before you even put a microphone on somebody, let's say you're going to do an interview with somebody, you have some things that you need to figure out before you even, you know, put that microphone on them. First of all, when you're figuring out where your lighting is, where your camera is, you need to figure out where your person is going to sit and which way they're going to sit, because that's going to influence where you're going to put your microphone. For example, if I'm talking this way, the microphone is okay on this side. Usually put the microphone in between you and the camera. If I were to move this way, okay, I'm going to want the microphone on this side of the shirt, okay? So then you can just take this off, flip it around and put it on this side, okay? It just makes your audio a little bit more clear when the person is speaking right to that microphone depending on which way they're going to turn. One of the other things to figure out, how are you going to attach that microphone to what they're wearing? Do they have a collared shirt on? Do they not have a collared shirt on? Just have, you know, a t-shirt or a shirt, you know, maybe a blouse or something that doesn't have a collar. Are you just going to set it down on a table fairly close to them so you can get some good clean audio? Those are things that you have to figure out before you can even put a microphone on. Okay, my third tip is for running the microphone outside of somebody's shirt. What you want to do is you want to put that microphone and run it around the back of them, okay, and bring it over one of their shoulders. And you need to figure out which way they're going to be facing as to which shoulder you want to run your mic cable over. Now, if they're wearing a collared shirt, the best thing to do is to take that microphone and run it underneath the collar, okay? And if the collar is buttoned, that's even better, because then you can run it through where it's buttoned and then clip your microphone right there. Now, running the microphone around the outside of the shirt is not the best way to put a wireless microphone on somebody. The chances that you'll see the cord are pretty good. If the person moves around a lot, you're gonna see the cord. But sometimes if you're, you know, in extreme hurry, you know, back in my news days, we had to get the audio right away. Sometimes that was just the best way to go. All right, my fourth tip for you also goes along with having the microphone on the outside of the shirt. But what happens with that cable? That cable might be running around out on their shoulder. Sometimes it falls down. What you can do is find just basic clips, right? So for example, this is a chip clip. I think it's a little bare, I think. But see, it's just a little chip clip, right? Like that. We've got little binder clips that come in different sizes. Very easy to carry. And then also like a clothespin. Just a basic, you know, clothespin that you can get from anywhere, or tape, gaff tape. Gaff tape works great too. Take one of these clips or take a piece of that tape, connect it to the cable on the back of the shirt collar. That way it's secure and connected underneath the collar, so that when they do move, that cable won't come sliding out and you won't see it. It'll be behind their head and no problem. Okay, for my next tip, if somebody's wearing a sports coat, tie, you know, they're dressed up really nice for their interview, usually I won't go through a shirt. I will just either attach it to their tie or I will attach it to the lapel of their coat. Again, you want to keep it kind of high. For the body pack and the cable then, what I do is I just tell them to go ahead and put it in their pocket, which is inside their coat right there. Now, a lot of people, you know, they carry their cell phones or glasses and things like that in that pocket. So they may have to take some stuff out to put that body pack in there. But put that body pack in, grab all that extra cable and just slide it in there as well. If you're putting the microphone on the tie, let the cable run all the way down the tie down to the bottom. And then you can kind of hide it through the coat as it comes up into their pocket. You can even have it, if you're not gonna see their pants, you can just have them, you know, clip it to their pants as well. One of the other tricks too with the tie is that on the back of every tie, you know, there's that little branding, I don't even know what to call it. There's that little tag that's in the back of every tie that sticks out from the tie. You can run that cable up through that as well, and then that will hold the cable all the way down through the tie. Okay, so now for running a microphone through the shirt, this is the preferable way to do it, and this is the way you should do it 99% of the time. For men, it's not such a big deal. Usually, you know, you just ask them, here, can you just run this, you know, run this through your shirt, and they have no problem and they do it. Now, I've found for women, it can be quite awkward, especially for you, for them, you know, it's kind of strange. So one tip that I have that I learned that works really well is to actually disconnect the connector from the body pack. And instead of having them take the microphone and run it up through their shirt, it's a little strange to do that for a woman. I give them the connector part and have them take it from their shirt here and drop it down through, right? And then they can drop it as much as they want. Give them as much cable as you can. And then they can drop it down through. Then usually they just have to reach down underneath their shirt, not very far, and grab the bottom part and then just continue to pull it through. Okay, for tip number 7, we're going to talk about attaching the microphone. We want to try to keep the microphone as hidden as possible. Now, sometimes that's not, it's not possible to do that. So you want to make it look as nice and neat as possible. So in this case, like I'm wearing, I have the microphone right here on the outside, but I have the cable curled around, okay? And then on the inside of the shirt, I have it curled around again under the clip, and then my cable is coming straight down. So at least it looks fairly nice. This is kind of what, you know, the news anchors do all the time. That microphone has to be out so you can have a nice clear audio, but make it look as nice as possible. Let's say like you're outside and you're doing an interview and it's windy, noisy. One thing that you can do is you can take that microphone and you can place it inside, let's say like they're wearing a coat, right? You place it inside of their coat. That way it hides the microphone, one, but two, it keeps all that wind noise from blowing into that microphone. Wireless microphones will pick up a lot more wind noise than a boom microphone. Jewelry, you've got to be careful of jewelry. A lot of women, you know, will want to wear, you know, something nice while you're doing interviews. And if you have your microphone attached to, you know, their blouse, let's say, and they have this, you know, necklace hanging down, it may hit that microphone and rub up against it. To go back to my last tip, if you have the microphone on the inside of a shirt or inside of a coat, you have to be careful of that as well, because the microphone could rub on that material and then you'll get, you know, noise coming from that as well. So just keep listening. Okay, now for the bottom part of the cable. That's part of the microphone as well. If you're going to be walking around doing interviews, you don't want to have the body pack and the cable just sticking out where everybody can see it. You've got to make sure that you hide everything. One of the tips is, you know, put a microphone or put the pack in a pocket. Of course, they all have clips on them, so you can clip them to the back of somebody. But also that extra cable, make sure you tuck that in. Tuck it into their pants. Or, you know, like I said with the sports coat, make sure that you tuck that into a pocket. That's all part of it in making sure that your interview looks good, sounds good, and looks very professional. For my last tip, when you're all finished, be very careful with the microphone. As I talked about in the very beginning of this video, this part is very delicate right in here. So what I suggest is that you actually disconnect this from the body pack when you're finished. Then take your microphone out like this, okay? And if you want to wrap it, you can. I always do mine, but I take my hand like this, okay? And then I very loosely, can wrap this cable like this, but I'm keeping the ends, the connection ends, and the microphone ends loose like that, okay? That way, and then you can, you know, you can twist tie, or you can use, actually, you can use one of the clips that you used from your shirt just to kind of hold on to that. But that keeps all the tension off of these cables down here, which will make your microphone last a lot longer. All right, so those are my tips and tricks on wireless microphones, especially this cable and the connecting end of a wireless microphone system. Thank you for joining me. Thanks for watching. Again, please go and subscribe to my channel and share this video. Like it, share it, all of that good stuff with all of your photography friends, video friends. Hopefully I can share some of this information with them so that they don't run into the same problems that I've run into. I'm going to end this video here. Thank you for watching. I'll catch you in the next video.